All right, coming up next, it's a light heavyweight championship fight between Jacare Souza and Gokhan Saki. All right, so here we go with round one. Seems to be a situation in which he wants to do everything in his power to keep this fight on the feet. He appears to have a lot of advantages at distance. We'll see if he can get it done tonight.
Yes, he has all the advantages because we don't see many specialists anymore in the UFC. Guys can generally do everything.
Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the gentleman. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one? Nice body kick right under the elbow.
Oh! Big shots exchanged in the pocket there. Combination lands for him. It was hard to see a miss in that sequence. He's put it all together.
I mean, everything is just flowing. It's like in a zone. It's like the basketball hoop.
Oh!
What a fight.
Oh, that's a big right hand. Whoa!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now. He's in trouble. He's getting lit up.
Total strikes have now landed for Jacare Souza.
Leg kick.
Oh!
Oh, he got him real good, too.
Oh, man. This ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land a beautiful ground and pound.
Oh, and he
he's hurt really bad. Guys come together, man. You just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very good. Wow. Actually got the takedown.
Oh, that's got to be discouraging as he gets right back up again.
He can barely stand.
Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Just missed on the front kick there. Whoa!
He needs to start looking to finish. Oh!
Seconds to go here in round one. So under 30 seconds to go in what has been a pretty entertaining and active first round. Big elbow there. Jacare gets touched, and once it, what a round. Both guys showing up in a big way tonight. So the crowd voicing its appreciation after that round. We had a knockdown courtesy of a punch midway through. DC, here's your highlight.
It was straight. He threw him in combination and landed that big punch that really did hurt his opponent. Lesser men would have been done. He's got a tough guy in front of him. He will have to go back to this again. He will have to get back to this action if he wants to get the desired finish.
All right, round two. Punch coming, it's blocked.
Oh!
Trying to establish that jab once again. Oh! Kick right under that right elbow.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
No!
He's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. God, that jab hurt him. Oh, he just hurt him.
fucking beautiful technical war here. If you enjoy this content, thank you. Don't forget to hit that follow, like, and subscribe. Thank you for your time. Have a good one.
This was a clinic tonight in terms of mixed martial arts acumen in every realm of the game.
A full-on display of all of his skills. He did everything in this championship-winning performance. He used his wrestling. He used his elbows. He used his pace and pressure to really wear down his opponent so that he can get his hand raised.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 58 seconds of round number two, declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC light heavyweight champion of the world, Gokhan the Rebel Saki.
Well, he came in as the undisputed UFC light heavyweight champion, and after that result, he goes out the way he came in, and still, ladies and gentlemen, and nice to see this moment now as he celebrates with his corner. That was as dominating a title defense as we've seen thus far this year, as he knocks out the number one contender, and really in so doing, sends a message to the other contender types at 205 pounds that it's going to take your best night and best performance, and even then, I'm still probably walking out with my belt.